Thanks for clicking on to WMUR.com. I'm meteorologist Derek Weglars. A beautiful day outside today, a lot of sunshine, and this is one of my favorite shots that I've seen so far this winter. Usually you think of ice and, well, winter by a lake. You think maybe you can walk outside on the lake. How about landing planes? This is the shot from Beth Carlson from the air, getting ready to land on Alton Bay itself, and this was the look from the ground. A lot of planes did make their landing today, and even a helicopter too. Really impressive stuff. Really cold the last couple of days, if not weeks, has really allowed for some areas and area lakes and rivers to really freeze up, and with a decent amount of ice too. We are in the 20s and lower 30s at this hour, so below freezing for most spots across the state, and clouds are building in from the west and the south here. We're basically sandwiched in between two systems. Weaker one towards the west will bring us our snow first thing tomorrow morning, and this ice storm will continue to move towards the south as we go through the day tomorrow. The ice storm that's brought ice to parts of Virginia and even the District of Columbia. So light snow into early Valentine's Day morning, but the main focus is for two storms in the forecast, the first one arriving late Monday into Tuesday. So this is futurecast through first thing tomorrow morning. There'll be a few flurries, especially towards the west across western parts of the state along the Connecticut River, but most spots are just overcast. There will be a few light flurries as we go into the afternoon, or light snow showers. The accumulation threat's very minimal. There's just not a whole lot of juice with this system, a lot of moisture with this to get things going through the afternoon. And it's not till Monday evening where the snow shower threat really begins to increase from the west. And that's when we'll find our emergence of heavier snow as we go into early Tuesday morning. So for tonight, we are down into the middle teens and lower 20s for most of the state. And for tomorrow, we're back up into the 30s, middle 30s south and west, with a little bit of sunshine through the afternoon. We will watch low pressure form along basically a stationary frontal boundary here, if you want to call it that, in parts of Georgia and even Alabama. And as this low begins to march towards the north and the east, it'll get a little bit stronger, but this is a very pronounced front. Very cold on the northern side, a little bit warmer on the southern side. So that sharpens the front and also really begins to get this snowfall going. To a point, or to that point, we are expecting a band of very heavy snow to arrive on Tuesday, with amounts of at least 8 inches expected at this point in the shade of blue. Further south, we are watching the potential for a mix, and a brief mix over to some sleets that mixes with the snow, and towards the north, 6 inches minimum, and it's a fluffier snow for that matter as well. So in terms of what we know, confidence highest with the storm timing, the exact amounts and the precipitation types, what falls from the sky, are still a little bit uncertain, at least at this point. But we are expecting snow to arrive on Tuesday, continue through the afternoon. Again, brief mix is expected south and east at this point. Wednesday looks very bright, and then on Friday, this is our next system that races in from the south and the west. It is much warmer than what we see on Tuesday, so I will expect snow, ice, and rain at this point as temperatures climb back up above freezing.